What's up, y'all? We are campinggeartv.com coming at you with one more episode.
And that's it? One more?
Yeah, after that, we're shutting it down.
That's it.
We're going to have plenty more, but the one we got today is we're taking a look at a tent from a company called Mountain Hardwear.
Yeah.
Really, really awesome stuff.
Yeah. It's the Mountain Hardwear Drifter 2, and it's a two-person tent, three-season, lightweight, a couple different options. So let's set it up and take a look at it. Come out like this, right? And so
it's got a nice little vestibule.
Yeah,
it's got it on both sides, the front and the back.
Right.
It's got two openings. Yeah, door on both sides.
Right. So as you saw when we were setting it up, it's really got the two layers. You got this top layer, which you can put on to give yourself a complete watertight seal. And then there's the first part of the tent, which has the mesh top and the main. It's got two doors, actually, right?
Yeah, I think
two doors.
Did you read? I thought I read somewhere in their site that you can also, that you can use just the rain fly too as a shelter.
Right.
You know.
Right. Yeah. So if you're doing like some lightweight backpacking,
yeah,
you can get this thing packed as light as about 4 pounds, and just use the top fly as a shelter.
Yeah, maybe if you get caught out in the rain or something like that, and you just need a place to chill for a little bit.
Right. So this tent costs about $150 to $160. Setting it up right away, you can look at it, and we'll show you a side angle as well. But like a lot of tents, it says two-person capacity, but you'd be pretty snug in there with two people.
Yeah.
But then again, we're talking about this is a good tent for backpacking.
Right.
So
it is lightweight. It's really lightweight. One of the lighter tents that I've seen.
Right.
And so, if you're trading off, if you're trading off a little weight to be, snug, if you got to do it, you got to do it. The setup was pretty easy, and the poles are very, very nice.
Yeah. So it's about 8x4. And as we were putting it together, I could tell that the tent is really well constructed. And Mountain Hardwear, they guarantee watertight. And so we asked them, what does that mean? And what they told us is that they guarantee that the tent won't leak. They test all of their tents in a rain room. And the rain room is tested with 1,200 inches of rain in a 24-hour period.
And no water leaks into their tents.
Yeah, so it's got a fully taped fly, a taped perimeter seam, welded corners and welded guy clip anchors, right? So it's it's pretty sturdy in the rain.
If you see here the bottom of the tent, it really in sitting in its form really comes up pretty high,
right?
So that it's not low to the ground at all, so no water can be creeping in or seeping off the ground. You're going to be well protected in there.
Yeah.
This isn't going to last in a hurricane.
Yeah.
Because it is very, very light.
Yeah.
But it's definitely a well-made tent.
Another thing about the quality of the product, I read on their site, it said that field repairs do not void the warranty. So, that's really a testament to them standing behind their product. A lot of people would say, a field repair, you void the warranty because you ripped the tent. Well, they understand what this tent's being used for, and they're down with it.
Right. I better watch what I say. Maybe the tent could survive being in a tornado or a hurricane. Because we're not able to test it in high winds today.
Right.
They definitely made sure that the tent is waterproof. They really stand by their product, that's for sure.
Right. So it's got the mesh canopy, like I talked about, for ventilation. The two doors, the canopies. It's got aluminum poles. Did we talk about that?
Yeah. Real light. They're real skinny.
Yeah. The aluminum poles. They're 7,000 series aluminum poles. Very nice. They snap together real easily. And if you're if you do a little research on poles, that aluminum poles generally are going to be a lot better for backpacking, for really any camping, than typical fiberglass that you find in a lower grade tent. And usually it's because it's going to be stronger, lighter. If it does happen to break, aluminum is real easy to fix, whereas fiberglass will shatter and is very difficult to fix.
I don't imagine that the poles would snap, only possibly like bend or dent.
Right, and then it's easy to...
Right, they're going to last a little bit longer. So the poles were very, very sturdy, and they look really nice, I'll just say that.
Right. So I think a good tent to backpack, especially with the super light option, it's the waterproof features of it pretty good.
It's like we said, it's extremely light, it's very airy, it's got the two windows on both sides, so although it's three season, I think this is a really, really good tent when you're like in the type of climate we are right now. We're sweating just standing here, it's so humid.
Yeah.
So in the evenings you need to make sure you're sheltered, but you have as much breathability and airflow as possible. And this tent definitely provides that.
Right.
You know, while at the same time, you know, it gives you a good rain fly in case you're caught out in the rain. You know, you got two vestibules on each side to keep gear, and a pretty good tent.
Yeah, thanks to Mountain Hardwear for hooking us up. Check us next time, campinggeartv.com.